mom gave her entire life for her kids. She was just about to enjoy herself without having to pack a lunch, or drive to dance class, or speak with a principal.
It's survivor syndrome, Argo. Okay? This is typical. I can get you through it. You know, Margo, there's a reason why you survived.
Yeah, give me one. I'd love to hear it.
Well, for one thing, without you, we couldn't speak with these aliens, could we? I'd say that's pretty important.
You really think so?
That's the first time you considered that?
I guess so.
You know, Margo, you survive because of your gift. I survive because of my book. You read my book, and it led you here. And there's a reason for that.
Which is?
I haven't figured that one out yet.
They're coming. Already? Time's up, Doc.
What do they want?
What do you mean? I told you. They want to destroy the planet.
No. They don't need your permission to destroy the planet. Ask them what they want.
You heard him. What do you want? They fear we're going to contaminate the entire universe. They can't seem to find even one reason why humans should continue to breed. They want to know why we should survive.
Are you sure?
Just one reason. Doc, I feel like I know them. Chapter 8.
Do they know about Chapter 8? Chapter 8. Well, a couple of weeks after my son was born, Jennifer took him up to Seattle to visit her mom. And her mom has a nice high-rise apartment. So, when they're there, the second night, the power goes out. And her mom's forced to use candles to light the place up. So, as the night goes on, one of the candles is left lit. And it falls over, and it starts a fire. And her mom gets out. But Jennifer and Kyle are stuck in the guest bedroom. And the fire traps them in the bedroom. And Jennifer wraps Kyle up and runs to the windowsill and waits for the fire trucks to arrive. And she waits. And she waits. And the witnesses say that she waited until the fire was... Her shirt was on fire. And when she jumped 8 floors down, she cradled Kyle, landed flush on her back, and she saved him. He got away with just bruises, but she died instantly. You know, some people tell you they love you. Other people show you. And the thing of it is, there's a million Jennifers out there walking among us. And that's humanity. Not the crap you see on the 6 o'clock news. That's humanity. And that's the stuff we're saving. What's happening?
They're leaving. They found a galaxy where there's a planet. No Jennifers. You did it.
The Phoenix Lights phenomenon seems to have disappeared as quickly as it arrived, leaving some astronomers to question the alleged involvement of extraterrestrials. The NSA is expected to release its official report on the occurrence early next week. In a related story, Phoenix clairvoyant Margot Sutter has decided to focus her energy on a campaign to mandate fire escapes for all high-rise apartments. In Cairo today,
you said when you died you'd walk with me every day. And I start to cry and say, please don't talk that way. With a blink of an eye, the Lord came and asked you to leave. You went to a better place, but it stole you away from me. Now she lives in heaven, but I know they let her to take care of me. There's a strange kind of light caressing me tonight. Prayer silenced my fear. She is near, bringing heaven down here. I miss your love, I miss your touch, but I'm feeling you every day. And I can almost hear you say, you've come a long way, baby. And now you live in heaven, but I know they let you out to take care of me. There's a strange kind of light in my bedroom tonight. Prayer silence my fear. She is near, bringing heaven down here. You taught me kings and queens while stroking my head. In my darkest hour, I know you are there, down beside.